And let's try the photos first. Ooh, there's a little indicator for when the camera is on. Let's set that as the wallpaper. Yeah! Now, let's try the video recorder. And we're gonna start recording on that.
Okay, from a flip phone perspective, you can tell it's not that good.
Ooh, the FPS is just like 10.
But let's check out the camera first. Take a picture. Let's set that as the wallpaper. Set. Yay! Now, let's try the video camera.
Okay, so on this screen, it looks pretty pixelated. I don't know if it's gonna look better on my computer, but it looks pretty pixelated on the screen.
But as always, let's check out the camera first. Okay. Okay. 3, 2, 1. How do you view the photos? Ooh, gallery. Ooh. Yes! See that? Let's set that as the wallpaper. How do you set it as the wallpaper? Share. Yes, wallpaper. Why is it giving me such a small crop? I want the whole thing. Good enough. Set. Perfect! Just look at that parallax scrolling effect. Now, let's try the video camera. Hit record. Whoa, you see this video quality? It's perfect! Look at that sun! Oh, I almost fell. Is my little setup.
As always, let's try out the camera first. Okay, hurry up please. Okay, finally. 3, 2, 1. Wow, everything on this phone lags. Really? The gallery's taking this long to load? I don't know what it's doing right now. Okay, finally. Okay.
I forgot to do a video test at the park, so I'm just gonna do it here.
Check it out!
Let's do some tests, starting with the camera. Alright, the first thing I noticed with the LG, what is the shutter button? Do you just press on the screen? Oh, cool. LG, 3, 2, 1. Beautiful. Alcatel? Ooh, I just noticed it has a flash. That's a nice touch. 3, 2, 1. Sorry, the shutter button's so small. 3, 2, 1. Beautiful. Now, let's do a video test. 3, 2, 1.
Hey guys, PlayRock124 here. I look like a freak with two phones. Hopefully, I don't get robbed today. Back to the video.
I can already tell, just by looking at the screen, that the Alcatel is better than the LG. Whatever, let's check out the camera. So there's one camera here, and one back here. It's on the bottom stuff here for some reason. Let's see if I can take a photo. This is gonna be kinda hard. I can probably just press the center button. 3, 2, 1. What about the front-facing camera? Flip that. 3, 2, 1. Let's try a video. Wow, this is the test of the front-facing camera on the ZTE Symbol T LTE. Now let's try a video with the back camera. Wow, guys. Flip phones are making a return to the trash. Keep that in mind when you're taking photos or video. Speaking of which, 3, 2, 1. Let's try the front camera. The box said it was VGA, same as the 3DS. And we're gonna compare it to the 3DS. Now, let's see how the video is.
Hey guys, right now I'm taking a video with the supposedly world's smallest smartphone. Just look at my new setup. I really made it.
Smartphone.
The speaker is actually not that bad. It's louder than the speaker on my camera.
Photos. No photos. Sure, I'll snap some right now. And I just realized there's no front-facing camera on a 2013 phone. Cool. Also, I don't think I see a flash on the back of the phone, but there's a flash option right here. Does that do anything? Nope. The flash option is just there to show you that you don't have any flash. Thanks. This is gonna be hard. 3, 2, 1. Got it. I would say that's decent quality. Okay, now let's do a video. Hey guys, right now I'm with the Nokia. Oh, it wasn't recording. I have to tap it again.
Hey guys, I'm with the Nokia.
I hate when they put the speaker on the back.
Oh, it kind of got flipped over. The white back did not do it any favors. The Nokia logo looks kind of cool now though. And it looks like the video's still going. We're just gonna stop that. Can I stop it? Oh, the screen is kind of cracked. I'm cracking the screen by peeling off the tape. If you can see, there's a crack going across the screen. Does it even respond to touch anymore? The damn thing's not even responding to touch now. Okay, the new award for the weakest phone on this series is the Nokia Lumia 530. Come on. It's supposed to be a Nokia, it's supposed to handle everything. Most of the screen was even covered by duct tape and the charger, so how can it break that easily? Look at this! Even more bullshit from this phone. I can't unlock it, so that means I can't approve it to import photos to my computer. So all the previous photos and videos I took, I can't import. I am labeling this phone as the worst phone of board smashing grocery store phones. The worst phone. Of course it's a Windows phone. Okay, let's check out the camera first. Oh my god, this is cool. If you turn to the back when the camera's on, you get this vintage throwback. Oh, I no longer want to be near this phone. Lot of ways you can make the subject you're photoing uncomfortable. Oh my god, that's so cool. I accidentally took a photo and that happened. What happens if you take a photo with the creepy eyes? Ugh. There's a camera on the front too, but I don't see the point in that when you can just mirror the display to the back camera and always see what you're shooting with the higher quality camera. 3, 2, 1. Ooh, look at all of these features it has. Let's try a lens blur. Gonna do this rock. Oh my. What's a photosphere? Okay. As you can see, this is what I have so far. Just line it up with the dots. It takes a photo, try to complete the sphere, but I do not have time for this, so yeah. And finally, let's do a video.
Hey guys, welcome to my crib, otherwise known as my own neighborhood. Yeah!
Let's first try the camera. It says ready, but it's loading, so take a photo. What? That is not a shutter sound. Listen to it again. It sounds like that time when I slammed a Joy-Con on the floor. Just notice the trash can graphic is glitched. Ooh, it has a burst mode. Let's see what happens. I just hope it's just like a bunch of smashing sounds. Yep, I was right. The iPhone at the time didn't have this many features in the camera. Even has a flash. I wish current iPhone software would have this option. Only this shot. And this phone also has video. Options. Call interruption. Block or allow. Man, I wish the iPhone had that. And start a video.
Hey guys, right now I'm doing a video on the GZ1 or the G-Zone or the whatever, GZ1, whatever they call it.
And when you're using the camera, this screen shows a camera icon, so you can't be a creep in public. Another feature of the screen, a lot of other flip phones had it, is that you can take selfies using this. Great resolution and color. Can't get over that shutter sound. And I just realized there's some photos that are already loaded onto it. What is this? The title describes it exactly.
What?
What? Have you ever been so sick you're mummified? On a football field or something? Cool. I wonder why this mascot didn't catch on. Ooh, live photos. I remember that my mom's old Verizon flip phone had this photo. And I set it as the wallpaper because I was impressed that a wallpaper could move. Nice.
Let's take a look at the camera on this thing. There it is. Alright, and I didn't think about this before, but I have to take out the battery again so I can put a micro SD card in it. Hopefully this works. Ooh, there was a light show. Back to the camera. I really like this joystick kind of thing. Switch to storage device. Trans unformatted. I'm guessing that's it. Format it. Trans. Just trans. 999 remaining. Alright, 3, 2, 1. Sure, let's store that. Oh yeah, this thing had a flash, even though the first, like, 3 iPhones never had a flash. I'm gonna try with the flash, and it's just the flash that just stays on all the time. That's much better. The flash helps. And I also read that this thing has video. Oh, we gotta see that. Videos, street scene. I love this 5 frames per second LSD scene. I want to shoot video. Come on, where's that? Oh, new video. 58 remaining. 58 minutes, 58 videos, 58 seconds, who knows? Hey guys, right now I'm recording video on the first. I think there's like a 5 second limit. Yep, there's a 5 second limit on videos. This thing is basically Vine before it was cool. I gotta make this video quick. Hey guys, oh god.
Hey guys, oh god. I'm shooting video on the iTunes phone.
Let's take a look at the camera. I'll keep that in mind. Ugh, this screen's so tall it's like impossible to reach stuff at the top. Let's try the selfie camera first. Wow, I look clear. I did spend $1,500, so... Alright, close the phone and then to activate the front camera. Yes, got it on my first try. I can easily take selfies with the main camera, so the selfie camera on the inside is kinda useless. 3, 2, 1. How do you take a photo? Oh, just tap. Let's try video 2.
Hey guys, right now I'm recording on the Motorola Razr front-facing camera.
No way, it's the rear-facing camera, but right now it's the front-facing camera, so I don't know what to call it. Video over. And the video quality doesn't look bad. But again, $1,500. And it's recording in landscape mode, so this would be kind of cool to vlog with. On something like this, you would have to turn it sideways and then you would just risk dropping it because of how hard it is to hold, but you just have to hold this like this, and it's easy. Oh yeah, you can also like vlog with the flashlight on, so you can see your face even in the dark. This is actually a really good vlogging camera choice. Okay, usually at this time, I would test the camera with the stock camera app, but since this is the BTS phone, we're using this to test the camera. 3, 2, 1. Yes, there's me and my boy, and my hairline. Now let's try for my boy Jungkook. Now a video.
Hey guys, I'm here with my best friend Jungkook and the BTS phone. Good luck in the military, you.
I wish they would let us use the front-facing camera, because it's kind of hard to angle yourself with the AR with the back-facing camera. Like, what friend would actually want to help you with this? While we wait for that to download, we can keep an eye on it while we test out the camera. 3, 2, 1. Does it always take that long to take a photo? Okay, it was just lagging a little bit, but it's fine now. And yeah, it only has that one camera, so I don't have to bother with taking multiple shots, so yay. There's a flashlight button on the lock screen, but make sure you have it turned the right way, otherwise you might accidentally flashbang yourself. Ah.
let's try out the video. 3, 2, 1. Hey guys, I'm coming to you live from the Surface Duo. I can also see on the second screen my app finally finished downloading, so we can open that up and finally enjoy Diary of a Wimpy Kid the way it was meant to be enjoyed.
Alright, peace, I'm gonna read Diary of a Wimpy Kid now.
Let's take a look at the features in order. First up, the camera. And there we are! It's very close up, not wide angle at all. 3, 2, 1. The camera shutter sounds like someone crumpling up paper. Can we even get the photos off of this? I gotta try that first.
Will it pop up?
No, maybe I have to go to settings.
Okay, I go to the storage setting. There is no USB storage mode, but there is a card option mode. Does this thing take micro SD cards? It kinda needs it since the space on this watch is 6 megabytes. Get off!
Yes, I'm opening it while it's charging because I want to be the first person that's electrocuted by a Sonic watch.
So far, I don't see a micro SD card slot. Do I have to lift up the battery that I'm not supposed to remove?
Found some tiny micro SD cards. This one's 4 gigabytes. Can it handle that?
And there it is, the most janky, unlabeled micro SD card slot ever. Card. Set to SD card successfully, yes! And there's no way to move this image to the SD card, so I'm gonna have to retake that photo.
3, 2, 1.
Save that. Okay, yeah, it should be charged fully enough. Now, we're gonna take a video. A video. A video. A video!
3, 2, 1.
Hey guys, just like as promised, my wrist hurts from trying to get this angle. I'm gonna be throwing away my DSLR now, okay? I don't know if you can see it, but bye, DSLR! You're no use to me now!
Ugh, I can't get this SD card out! Come on, yes!